Hi, everybody. This is Bob Carey coming to you from First Trust offices right in the middle of the day here on the 25th of August. The markets have been certainly a lot calmer than they were last week. The market so far this week actually is on the upswing, and it appears that as if investors are feeling a little bit better about what's going on. And at the same time, we're starting to see some news of some major investors taking on some pretty big stakes, as witnessed by Warren Buffett's purchase of a big stake in Bank of America. Now, the fact is the markets could not have been any more volatile than they've been over the last couple of weeks. And so the markets did look to be quite oversold. We've recovered. It seems like we're going through a lot of the same issues right now at the Dow at about 11,000 that we went through last year with the Dow at about 10,000. And you think about it, most companies in the Dow are up about 10% in revenues compared to last year. And so here we are. We're pretty much reliving what we went through. But profit margins actually in the last three, four, five quarters actually are better than what they were a year ago. So valuations actually have come down. And so when investors like a Warren Buffett see share prices down and they can buy more companies and more earnings for their dollars, they are going to put capital to work. And it makes complete sense to us. So the one basic message I want to convey today is that we're starting to see the big money, the block share investors, the people who have major capital looking at the situation as an opportunity to get more for their money. They see more risk. Obviously, we all see more risk in the economy, but the fact is, like I talked about last week, you get more reward when you buy more value and buy at a lower price, and that's exactly what's going on. Now, we're going to hear from the Fed tomorrow. I'll let Brian and Bob Stein comment about that over the weekend and perhaps in their Monday morning outlook, but the fact is that we have an economy that looks like it's growing slowly, and perhaps some of the issues that were holding the economy back in the first half of the year, especially the tsunami in Japan, the earthquake, and a lot of the weather we had here in the U.S., some of those issues appear to be going by the wayside. We had a very strong industrial production figure for the month of July that was reported a few weeks ago that was largely ignored. And then this week we got a very good number on industrial production and capacity utilization. In other words, we're starting to use more of our nation's factories, mines, utilities. The output there is picking up, and then that number was very strong coming into July. Now, we may have some disappointing economic data as a result of the economy maybe spooking some people, but so far we don't see any signs of any kind of an economic panic today anywhere near like we went through a couple of years ago. So we're basically saying, look, there's a lot of value out there. The smart money is taking advantage of these prices right now. Stock prices on a valuation basis are lower than they were back in the mid-90s. You've got to go back to the mid-1980s to find valuations at these levels. And I got back in the business back then. That was about the beginning of my career. And we had much higher interest rates. So compared to what you see available to you as far as competition and interest rates, you're getting a lot more earnings, if you will, for your dollar on the investment side of this market. So with that, we'll check back in with you, of course, next week. In the meantime, to our friends on the East Coast, you're definitely in our thoughts and prayers and hope that things turn out okay. So we'll see you next week.